I don't know if you guys can see that, but if you can't see that, you can probably see my elbows giving out. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to replace this jacket. To give the Flash jacket a proper send-off, this will not be the last video it's in. Next video I have, though, that's its last video. It's a sad day indeed, but what isn't sad is what we're looking at today. So over the past few years, I've shown you guys some devices that seem far too good to exist in a world like ours. Today's another one of those days, because today we are taking a look at a $30 wireless pro controller sent over from our friends at EasySMX. The ESM9110. Don't worry, it comes in black. They sent me this color and I have no idea why, but it comes in black. It's on the box. Out of all the controllers I've tried, this one has to be the most surprising by far, by a large margin. It's not even close. And I'll be detailing why throughout the remainder of this video, so be sure to stay with me through this ad break. Just kidding, I'm not that much of a cunt. I'm a YouTuber. I'm just not like every other YouTuber. So what exactly is the ESM9110? Well, it's a wireless Switch-oriented controller. And I say Switch-oriented because even though it's compatible with Switch and it's advertised as being for the Switch, it's compatible with PC, PS3, and Android. And to be honest, it works much better as a PC controller. I mean, look at the wireless dongle. Like, is anyone putting this in their Switch? You guys see this? What the shit am I doing? My hand's a terrible reference. Is that better? I don't know. Help me. Personally, I think the dongle is just a bit too big for someone who's on Switch, but I don't own a Switch. I'm not a Switch user, so I can't say for sure, but I would have to say that if I was on Switch, I probably wouldn't be using this because of that dongle. So like I said earlier in this video, this controller is $30, and to be exact, right now, on the website, it is $32.99, and it has a base retail price of $35.99, but I haven't seen it at $35.99 for the past few weeks, so I don't know. The website unfortunately doesn't give you too much detail. It gives you a surface level understanding of the controller, but it doesn't give you all of it, which is really the only critique I have of the website. It just needs to be a little bit more informational. That, and they do Photoshop these controllers in some of these pictures, and it's very, very fucking obvious. I'm on to you, EasySMX. Don't think you can get away with that. I'm a Photoshop god. What exactly are you getting for 35 bucks though? Well, you're getting what is essentially a Switch controller. So it's using USB-C, surprisingly, but it's not a fast charger. It takes 2.5 hours to charge, and for 2.5 hours of charge, you're getting 8 hours of playtime, which isn't the best ratio ever. But I really can't complain all that much. It's $30. And it's wireless, and it has buttons on the back. Speaking of the buttons, there are 4 individual buttons, but they are made out of 2 solid buttons. They kind of like rock back and forth. You have 2 buttons right here, 2 buttons right here. These buttons are actually extremely comfortable, at least M3 and M4, which are the ones that are on the back here, right here, and these are M1 and M2. These ones are really, really comfortable. They just conform to your hand. It's a bit more difficult to use the ones that are on the bottom of the controller because they're on the bottom of the controller. But I really do like this button layout, and especially for 30 bucks, you can't find something better than this. Mapping the buttons is really easy. All you have to do is use one of the faceplate buttons, which we'll be going over here in a little bit. Right next to your turbo button, there's something called the back button, which is a Switch thing, I'm assuming, because I'm not a Switch user. What you do is you hold the back button, press the paddle you want, and then it'll turn pink. All you have to do from there is then press the button that you want to map it to, and it'll flash, and then you press the paddle that you want to map that button to, and it turns blue. And there you go. Your button's mapped. It's not the simplest way of button remapping, but it works. These buttons are extremely comfortable. They're not my favorite set of buttons, to be honest, because this controller is a bit smaller and it makes it a bit uncomfortable for me personally. I am an Xbox controller user after all, but I really do like them, and like I said, for the price, can't beat it. What's also cool is you can remap these to any button on the controller, including your bumpers and your triggers. So that's a big plus, because I've seen a lot of pro controllers that you can't remap the triggers or the bumpers for whatever fucking reason. Some other buttons that I'm really into on this controller would have to be the bumpers and the triggers. These are some of my favorite by far. The bumpers aren't as clicky as the stock Xbox controller bumpers, but they are much easier to use. They feel a lot more ergonomic, but not only that, they're a lot easier to press down. Stock Xbox controller bumpers are a bit resistant. These ones are just, it's not like they don't have any give. It's almost like they're, how do I put this? It's like they're membrane, but they're not membrane. They're like clicky, like mechanical feel keyboards. That's what it's like, but with controllers. Do you get what I'm saying? you don't get what I'm saying. Doesn't matter. Like I said though, these triggers are amazing. They conform perfectly to your hand. They're really like spongy almost. They feel great. Almost like they give you a little bit of resistance too. So it almost feels like you have like an actual trigger here. The only issue is that in my driving games, the throttle isn't all that spot on. It's a bit annoying because sometimes the throttle works at 100% and sometimes it's like, it wants to sit between 20 and 100%. It doesn't really want to choose what it wants to do. Now, my favorite part of this controller would have to be the thumbsticks. They have this soft touch, like almost like a rubber texture on top of them. And these little side grip thingies are made out of this rubber that's, it almost feels like squishy, but it's not squishy. It doesn't squish around. It's not weak shit. It's like a hard rubber, but it feels much better than the Xbox One controller's rubber. Not only that, but these thumbsticks in comparison to like a PS4 DualShock or an Xbox One controller, these thumbsticks are actually quite thin, which makes for a much, much different experience. As opposed to something like my Razer Wolverine Ultimate, these thumbsticks do feel a lot quicker, and they also feel a whole hell of a lot more comfortable. But the longevity of these thumbsticks, so like stick drift or shit like that, I'd have to wait. And that's the issue with third-party controllers, is that you never have any insight into how these things are going to perform 6 months from now or a year from now. Now, since this is a Switch-oriented controller, it is based off the Switch design with the Xbox button layout, but the Switch sizing, which means that this controller is a bit small, and as a Xbox controller player, it's a bit too small for me. I do like this controller, and I am going to use it in some of my games. Don't you worry about that one. But the issue with it is, since it's so small, it's a bit cramped down here for me, but it does make things like using the ABXY buttons and the bumpers and the triggers, it makes using those buttons much easier, so I suppose it's an okay trade-off to have uncomfortable paddles with a much more comfortable controller than, you know, have an Xbox controller that's decently comfortable but with shitty paddles. Now, as you guys may have seen, there's some RGB action going on here. It's not really RGB, it's just the ABXY colors, and then you have this ring around your right stick. That ring glows pink when you're remapping your shit. And if you're using the turbo button, which we'll talk about here in a minute, it's glowing red. You also have 5 levels of brightness off, and then 4 levels of, well, brightness, which is accessible through a button on the bottom of your controller. So including off, you have 5 levels of brightness, and there's also the exact same button for vibration, which is right next to it. This has 5 levels of vibration, including off again. The last button we'll talk about before we go on to turbo is the mode button. The mode button is the button you'll be pressing and holding when you want to switch modes, which are categorized via these lights right here on the controller. It's a really complex system, especially when it comes to the Switch side of things, so I'll put some graphics on screen now for the indicators on the LEDs. Right now, it's lighting up 1 and 4 for PC, because, you know, I'm PC Raster Race Roy. Master Race Boy. Last but certainly not least, though, is the turbo button, which I don't use because it's cheating like a motherfucker, but some people will probably want to use it. The turbo button is rapid fire. You can give rapid fire to any button on this controller. All you need to do is hold the turbo button, press the button you want turbo with. That's it. You want to turn turbo off? Press the turbo button, hold it, and press the button that you want to turn the turbo off on. Now, like I said, I don't use this, but you could. I don't like encouraging people to do bad things, but you can use turbo on your triggers. You can use it on your bumpers. You can use it on anything. And it's probably going to help a lot of people out now that I've said it. Aside from turbo, I love everything about this controller. It's a Switch controller, so it's a bit on the smaller side, so people with smaller hands can use it. It's cheap, it's really accessible for everybody, the paddles are nice, the qualities and the features of it are extremely unheard of for a price point like this. And on top of all that, I don't think I mentioned this, but it has a soft touch faceplate, which is like, you know, a big fucking deal. I'm absolutely in love with this controller, and to be honest, I would 100% recommend it for people looking for a PC controller that's on the cheaper side, or just something to use for your first-person shooters, whatever the hell. I mainly use this for my driving games because I love these triggers. I mean, they fuck me up a lot, but I have a lot of fun with this controller. I even use this for, like, third-person shooters, too, and it works just fine. If you're someone who wants a wireless experience with some paddles on the bottom for next to nothing when you start thinking about other controllers like the Elite Series 2, the Razer Wolverine, this will do you just fine. And if you are interested in this, I will have a link down below, so be sure to go check that out. But yeah, I think that's going to do it for this one. This is a video I was really, really excited about, and I really do hope that I could have helped some of you guys out with finding a controller that you know, just works. To be 100% honest, you don't even have to get this as a controller that just works. You could just use this controller on the regular, and I'm pretty sure you'd be just fine. Anyways, though, I sincerely hope you guys enjoyed this one. Okay, you're a dick. Stop, asshole. Stand. All right, we gotta go shout out our members. By the way, the channel's been performing like... I don't even know what to compare it to at this point. I really have to thank you guys for that. And a special shout out to these boys. For the console tier, we have the Ballin' Boy, JG, Waterless, Heberbrine 3, God, Snowy Ice Cream, Tuff, XO Casper, and Morhib Hussein. And in the PC Master Race tier, we have Noah Jacques, D Jacques, which, yes, they are the same person, and Ra. Y'all motherfuckers are the realest, even when I'm not posting the best content. I appreciate you. I really can't thank you guys enough for the performance in the channel lately. It's actually been fucking insane. Like, I was not confident that I could hit 10k by the end of the year, and I'm still not confident that I can hit 10, but I could hit like 9, which is like a big fucking deal. I was at 1,000 subscribers a year ago yesterday. Literally, no, I'm recording this November 17th. November 16th, 2019, I had 1,000 subs. November 17th, and I'm at like 7 billion or some shit. Anyways, I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. I really enjoyed making it. If you did, please be sure to drop this one a fat like and a subscribe. A subscribe down below. Yeah, a fucking subscribe. Hand me a subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Peace.